Hello everyone, my name is Bjorn, and welcome back to Yakuza Like a Dragon. And I believe this is the finale. And we are gonna go ahead and face off Ryo Aoki. And he has a gun. The coward that he is.
You think you can defeat me, unarmed, one-on-one?
You think you can blah blah, and then you're always proven wrong.
Now we're talking. I'll wipe that stupid grin off your face and leave it bloody on the floor.
You're too full of yourself, man. Too full of yourself. Yeah. Okay, I can't use the tag team, but let's try this roadside weapon. Oof. Got it. Okay, I wasn't used. I think I'm back to my freelancer job too. I can't use any of my other skills. Let's try this one. Ooh. Oh. Just beating him up. Yeah. You said you had a lot of money? Here you go. Let's do another suplex on you. Boom. You weren't even worth using my primary job. It's gonna keep on using a suplex against you. Oh, it's my turn again. Let's do a double suplex. Boom.
Your face pisses me off.
That's a lot of emotion. So here, let me put something in your face. Yeah, let me end this with, you know, the very first kill I ever use in this entire game. Gonna use the tenacious fist.
Come on.
Nice.
That all you got?
This fist fighting.
Fuck you.
Yeah, maybe this is all they needed, was just to punch each other. I misclicked that one. I thought it was an E.
Ichiban! I'm not done yet.
Escape? That was a surprise. Well, they're fighting downstairs too. Another escape. Oof. That was quite a punch. Did that end it?
Ichiban.
Why not?
Ichiban.
After everything you've done to everybody else? After killing everybody else?
To put this nation on the right path. I can use my power.
What light? You got a lot of people. You placed a lot of people in danger.
And then what? What's that have to do with anything? And then I can...
make Japan.
This whole political so talk. This is what you really feel?
I could do that. That's what the masses want. They want peace and prosperity.
And can you really?
But the reality is, you just do whatever you want and make other people clean up after you. What? No matter who you claim to be now, if anyone disagrees with you, even a little,
you toss them
aside like they mean nothing.
Kill them off.
I already know you're just gonna keep using the state of Japan as an excuse to kill the people around you, just like you did with your father.
That was your father.
If I hadn't done anything, you would have killed Captain Sawashiro, even after he served you for more than 20 years. There are two types of people in this world.
Okay, what bullshit are you gonna say now?
Those who use, and those who get used. In other words, people who can make a difference.
And all about that,
just
man.
Tools in their hands. Like your father. He was just one of many tools. Useful while it lasted.
You're screwed up, man.
So what you're saying is that it's fine for certain people to be sacrificed once they've outgrown their use to you? Are you finally...
You mean getting the picture? You're just really...
Like hell I am!
It's a little bullshit.
You and me, we're like light and shadow, born on the same day. You're the light. Harakawa's heir and legitimate son, who was always given everything I ever wanted. You had all of that from birth. What the hell happened? What changed you? Why'd you turn out like this?
This is the police! Nobody move a muscle!
Kasuga, these aren't just beat cops. They probably report directly to the commissioner.
Sir! What's going on here?
Why don't you start over from scratch? Come on. That's exactly what you need to do. I know you can crawl back up if you just put in the work. I believe in you.
This guy
is willing to do that. I swear I'll stand by your side the whole time. Just like the old days, for as long as it takes, we can do it.
Damn, your loyalty is like off the charts, Ichiban.
You know something? Back when I first joined the family, I promised Arakawa-san that I'd always be there to support you. As you already know, Tendo tried to use a bomb to kill us back in Ichincho. He did all that under the orders of Ryo Aoki. We have video evidence of Aoki's reaction when he found out we were still alive.
Did you upload that now?
We know he must still have accomplices out there somewhere. At the very least, someone who ran that ticker at the same time as the votes were being counted. And we know someone must have been hiding him after the explosion in Ijincho. I refuse to tolerate any chance of another close shave like this.
So, what's your call here?
Hunt them all down. Kill them. Make sure the bodies are never found. Do whatever it takes.
Oh my gosh.
I don't want even the slightest chance.
Is he gonna kill himself?
Of any of them getting back up and crawling out of the slums like cockroaches.
No, he's too prideful to do that. He's probably gonna hurt someone.
This video's already making its rounds on the internet. The Citizens Liberal Party must have more enemies than they think they do, because it's going viral even as we speak.
I think it's fair to say we'll need to consult with the commissioner on this one. Things aren't looking good for you, Mr. Governor. We'll need to take you into custody. Why don't you come with us to the precinct?
He has a weapon with him.
You master! Oh,
stay back! Take one step, and I blow his fucking brains out! Your master! Don't do this!
Yeah.
You want me to give up everything I've built because of some stupid thing Arakawa told you 20 years ago?
Yeah, he's so...
All this patriarch and old bullshit. I've always hated how you Yakuza act like you're one big, happy family. You go on about duty and honor, and I fucking hate it. I fucking hate it!
Put the gun down, young master, please. If you take a police officer hostage, they're going to kill you, no matter who you are. I don't want to see any more of my family die.
Family? Don't make me laugh. Yeah,
this guy is so effed
your
up.
Fucking family.
No matter what you say, I'll always consider you part of my family. You were the first friend I ever had in my whole life. I wish I could have stopped you. I should have stopped you from losing control, but I didn't. And now we've both lost Arakawa-san forever. So please, don't do this. I couldn't take losing you too. You can still come back. I'm begging you.
You just like him. Every single damn thing that comes out of your mouth just reminds me of my fucking father. Which is exactly why I never liked you in the first place.
Man, this guy is getting away, and also is doing something really stupid. Seriously, is it not yet over? Holy shit. Uploaded it here on public.
I don't want even the slightest chance of any of them getting back up and crawling out of the slums like cockroaches. Knock them all down. Kill them. Make sure the bodies are never found. Do whatever it takes.
It's like the same when he was walking and he lost like the power on his legs. He's back. He's here on the lockers. That's where it all started. You found him, Ichiban?
I told you. I've known you for 20-odd years.
I figured you'd come here. Call it a hunch. I thought maybe some of my words managed to get through to you. Maybe you actually did decide to start over from the bottom and work your way back up.
I don't know, Ichiban.
I figured if you did, you'd come back to where Arakawa-san first found you. Where our stories began.
You don't have any idea what I'm going through. I'm tired of your shit, Ichiban.
All we're doing here is having a conversation. So come on. The gun's really not necessary. Why don't you stop pointing that thing and give it to me?
She was a hostess who broke my heart and betrayed me on that New Year's Eve 18 years ago. That night changed
really
our lives forever.
Really was because of that.
She ended up marrying Horinouchi, you know? Before I became governor, I attended a celebration of his appointment to police commissioner. She was there. She didn't recognize me. Everything about me was so different. Do you know what she said to me? You won't believe it. Oh my, you're so sophisticated and intelligent for a man your age. Crazy, right? Fucking incredible. That damn woman. She was so scared of me. And she calls me a gentleman? What kind of bullshit is that? I swear you couldn't make this shit up! Hilarious, don't you think?
That's okay.
In the end, that's all it amounted to. The power I changed my name for, changed my body for. The power I chased with such blind passion, I killed for it.
Oh.
I started off in life with a weak, ugly body that embarrassed me. I worked hard to improve myself. But after all that, I still wasn't happy because no one appreciated who I really was on the inside.
That's not true, young master. The boss, I mean, Arakawa-san and Captain Sawashiro both cared about you. They always put you first in everything they did. Same for me. After I got out of prison, the first time I saw you was in a picture. I knew it was you right away. There was no mistaking it. I'd recognize your face anywhere. Because I care about you too.
Yeah, even though he changed his face, Ichiban was able
to
recognize
him. Are you lecturing me again about how important family is?
No! It's not a lecture! Did you ever stop to think why Arakawa-san, Captain Sawashiro and I never gave up on you? No matter how much bad shit you dragged us into! Let me tell you. It wasn't easy. But we did it anyway, because we're all connected, deep inside our hearts. You see things in black and white, but family's not that simple. No one appreciated you for who you are? Bullshit!
We were always there for you. We would have done anything for you. Gone to hell and back. All you had to do was ask. When will you believe me when I say the three of us loved you? Or are you just gonna keep pointing that gun on your head like a dumbass?
Ichi.
This may not be what you want to hear, but you know, I consider you my brother, man. That means something to me. Don't make me watch my brother die. Please. I can't do it. Masato. I'm begging you.
Mr. Governor, where are you?
Sorry, I didn't mean to worry you. I'm going to turn myself in. Would you mind taking care of the... No, never mind. You're free to do as you like. Goodbye.
Yes, Aoki-san. I put my faith in you. I believed your words. I thought you would lead us down a noble path, bleached pure and clean. But it's not too late.
Fucking Kume?
True righteousness will triumph.
Someone recording this? What? You're ending things here? I'm upset. Shit, I'm so upset. Get to learn what happens here next. Is this the police commissioner? Isn't it? He was like a loose end here.
I'm glad you decided to show up, Horinouchi-san.
Dachi. Finally got him.
Of course. You must be him. The man who sent me that anonymous tip. As I recall, you're Kanagawa police.
The name's Adachi. I was at the driver's license center, but I was dishonorably discharged just before I hit retirement. Hey, you know, this didn't happen too long ago. Don't tell me you don't remember me.
Your point? I'm a very busy man, you know. Don't waste my time, please. Look, you said there was a crime the Tokyo Omi Alliance had gone unpunished for. Can we get to that?
I found some pretty explosive evidence at the Arakawa family office in the Millennium Tower. I'm not sure if you know this, but supposedly there was an audio recording somewhere in the office that would implicate Governor Aoki in Masumi Arakawa's murder.
But that was just a bluff by Ichiban Kasuga and his accomplices.
Okay, so this was after.
To lure out Tendo and the governor. A trap to record Aoki admitting to his crimes.
I knew you'd have a good grasp of it. Oh, you brought company. These guys your subordinates?
I'm the police commissioner. Every officer is my subordinate.
Fair enough.
USB.
What's that?
The recording might have been a hoax, but when Tendo and the Omi searched the family office, they found something else that was very interesting. Simply put, it's a list of shady characters who are on the Arakawa family payroll.
Is it?
Apparently, not long after the Kamurocho 3K plan started, Masumi Arakawa transferred a total of 300 million yen to various officials in public roles. Shame he was killed the other day, huh? You know, I think he could have explained in detail what all these obvious bribes were about. But at least we have this list here, which shows exactly into whose hands each yen landed. That's right. The whole list is here. It was all on Captain Sawashiro's computer. Great news for us, don't you think? What's up? Oh, you're looking kind of pale, Commissioner. Is something wrong? Masumi Arakawa's 300 mil took crazy complicated routes through a bunch of foreign bank accounts. Eventually found its way to you and other high-ranking officers. I know it was all in exchange for turning a blind eye toward the Omi Alliance activities in Kamurocho. For real, I gotta hand it to Arakawa for hiding the flow of this money so well, but lucky for us, this list makes it pretty clear. So, all we need is some supporting evidence, and then the arrests from this little guy are gonna knock out dozens of top officials, including you, police commissioner.
Arrest this man! Confiscate whatever you find on him! What's wrong? Those are my orders!
Struggle all you want. It's too late now, you moron. I already sent this to the Inspector General at Police
HQ. Adachi.
That's right. Toss the same thing over to the media, so your time's running out. Tick-tock, Commissioner.
You're bluffing. This whole scheme wouldn't benefit you at all. You'd be just as poor afterward as you are now.
No, this isn't a bluff, unfortunately for you. It's a victory for me.
Yeah. Way to go, Adachi.
Commissioner, the Inspector General is eager to have a word with you.
What?
I'm sure you didn't take the money purely for personal gain. You had a duty to protect the peace in Kamurocho. After the Tojo clan disappeared, you had no choice but to allow the Omi to take over and stabilize the area. In that sense, you might have even felt you were justified in taking the bribe because of the position you were in. I feel for you. You were caught between a rock and a hard place, weren't you? But on the other hand, sir...
What?
What a coincidence that doing the right thing for the city also happened to line your own pockets. How much was it exactly? 1 mil? 10 mil? Even more? Well, I'm sure we'll find out once we analyze the data. You handed out bribe money to avoid taking responsibility for the city's crime rate. Plus, you even got to skim some for yourself. People who have so much always want more. Why don't you just admit you did it to save your own damn skin? Just like the old days, eh, Horinouchi?
Bastard.
You know, I've been waiting for years to see exactly that look on your face.
This is a trap! A conspiracy! I won't stand for it! Let go of me! I order you to let go of me!
Oh, yeah! Mind if I ask you one more thing? Do you remember New Year's Eve 18 years ago? There was this rude Yakuza who cock-blocked you from your own wife at a hostess club.
What did you say?
Never mind.
Oh. Now what happened to Ichiban? Are we ending here with Adachi? There's more. Yeah, passed away, it seems.
Ichiban. Joe Sawashiro received his sentence. He got life in prison.
Yeah. In fact, I was just telling the boss all about how everything shook out.
It's just tragic. Masato Arakawa died without ever knowing Sawashiro was his father. And Masami Arakawa died without ever knowing what happened at the lockers that night, and that you were his real son.
Yeah, that sucked.
A DNA test?
Yeah. Why not? It's the only way to prove once and for all if Arakawa really was your dad. Don't you want to know for sure? Otherwise, you're gonna have doubts for the rest of your life. I mean, if I were in your shoes, I'd want to know.
Not me, man. The way I see it, I have two dads.
Huh?
My fathers are Jiro Kasuga, owner of Shangri-La, and Masumi Arakawa.
He already sees him as his dad ever since. It doesn't matter which one I'm related
to by blood. Nothing can change the fact that they both raised me and made me who I am today. I don't need a test.
Okay. That's something, man.
Huh? Oh, there you are. What are you guys doing in here? The services are starting. Let's go say goodbye to the Arakawas.
All right, let's go.
They're here.
Kasuga, good to see you.
Likewise. I heard about what you've been up to. You started a security company in Sotenbori.
Yeah, that's right.
Sotenbori.
We had to do something for all the guys who had their rug swept out from under them. Their Yakuza in the wind. I saw it all coming, so I wanted to give them somewhere to go.
Originally, Arakawa-san was supposed to help us put the whole plan in motion.
Yeah. I heard something about that.
Well, what's your next move, Kasuga? You with us?
Yeah, sounds like your dad had some unfinished business. Why don't you come to Osaka and wrap this up for him?
I think hell just froze over. The mad dog of Shimano is giving perfectly reasonable advice.
Don't get used to it. Today's an exception. Tomorrow it's back to balls out.
I appreciate the invitation, but I can't. Ijincho is my home. Looking back on it, in Komurocho I was drifting all by myself. But here in this town, I found my people, and nothing can replace them. You see, I owe them, and I need to pay them all back for what they did for me. Ijincho and Sotenbori should be places where people can go when they're lost. Safe havens when there's nowhere left to turn. So you see, I can take care of the boss's unfinished business right where I am now. That's my plan anyway.
I get it. Makes sense to me.
Master.
Hey, wait!
Hey!
Oh, it's them.
What the? What are all you guys doing here?
Well, Namba here was all worried about you. He thought the ex-Tojo guys might be looking to snatch you up, Kasuga-kun.
Hey, I said to keep that shit on the down low.
So? What'd you say to those old thugs? You gonna leave town and forget all about us little guys?
Zachan, how about you tell him?
What?
I can't say all that mushy shit again while I'm sober.
Well...
Wow, I didn't think he loved us that much.
Did he say it just like that? How cute.
Sounds like the Kasuga-san I know.
Finally. I've gotten to a point in my life where I can't be replaced. What an honor.
Hey, as long as I'm in there, he's got good taste.
Thank you.
Once you're at rock bottom, the only place to go is up. There's no shame in being at the bottom. All that matters is how you decide to climb back out of the darkness. There's always a ray of hope up there. I was lucky to learn that from you, young master.
Okay, wow. We have finally finished Yakuza Like a Dragon. I think, you know, I've, like all the Yakuza games, I've enjoyed the story very much. The gameplay of this one is vastly different from the previous titles. Even though it's turn-based, it is still enjoyable. Though I still prefer a bit of the beat-em-up mechanics of the previous games. Kind of feel like I'm in control of, like, how long I can like end the fight, so that's something that I've enjoyed a lot more in the previous games, but that doesn't mean that I didn't enjoy the combat of this one. So, you know, it just sucks that, you know, Ichiban lost his like his father, his real father, and also the young master who was like a brother to him, and it's always just a tragedy for these, you know, the main characters. So, you know, it almost got me, you know, it almost got me thinking that, you know, Ryo might actually change and then they turn their life around, but they'll just be like in prison or something like that. I also had this fear that he might get shot by the cops. Okay, wait, these guys. Oh, shit. Okay, as I was saying, the story almost got me to thinking that, you know, Ryo or Masato Arakawa was gonna survive. But I also had that fear that he might get shot once the police gets there, especially since he did take a police hostage and then he could get shot for it, for what he did. Especially when he was still holding the gun at some point. But, you know, that gave me a little bit of hope, even though, you know, previously I really hated that guy's guts. There were like parts of it early on I was like, yeah, this guy is irredeemable and whatnot. But then I also got to a point where I wanted to see how he can redeem himself, like starting from the bottom and up, just trying to like do things that would just, you know, he would take the consequences for his actions and also try to make things up for those he has hurt. And fucking Kume, right? That asshole is also got into that delusional point that's almost like no return. But seeing how Masato Arakawa was able to snap out of it, even though, you know, it took so long, you know, it almost got me thinking that guy won't ever like change his views and whatnot. But, you know, overall, you know, that just stings for Ichiban. It's like it was all set up just for us to feel like Ichiban has a brother at the end of all this, only to get snagged away. You know, I felt more sad because Ichiban lost someone that he sees as a brother, but not more of like the death of that guy. So yeah, that has been fun. That has been great for the Yakuza game. I've heard that the new Yakuza game, the sequel, is gonna come out I think later this year or next year, and I'm really excited to try that out. Before that happens, I might start playing Judgement and also Lost Judgement, because those are the Yakuza games I haven't been able to play yet, and perhaps also Ishin. Though in the foreseeable future, I might start playing Mass Effect and also Deathloop. Those are like the games I have on my bucket list. I haven't played or seen much of Mass Effect, just a few spoilers about it, but it's a game that I've always wanted to try. So if that's your thing, I do hope that you stick around and watch my playthrough of it. And that's about it. Thank you so much for watching Yakuza Like a Dragon, And as you can see here, this is the costume that we have unlocked when finishing the game. It's called True Hero, which is like Masumi's fit, Masumi Arakawa's fit. And yeah, I hope to see you on the next one. Bye!